Alright, so guys, welcome to your first day training. So we're still following up on what we did last week
or
two weeks ago. Was using the mic, but most important, covering classes. So like Sheila said today, it's worst case if you guys have to cover. It's what we can do if we need to set up in the studio and deliver a class. So most likely a secret class. So just before we start, anyone can tell me with your words, how can you describe a secret class? What is a secret class? Anyone's
breaking up? Class, it's a group of exercises that you do one after another.
Yeah.
Full body workout.
Full body workout, exercise to do.
Like the routine
of
the
secret. Yeah. What are we training when we're doing this?
It's more metabolic conditioning.
Conditioning, strength.
Endurance.
Stamina as well.
Stamina as well.
Because like the circuit is beneficial with the circuit, it's very useful for the circuit that has a physical nature.
Yeah, exactly.
It's very nice, it's very good for the beginners.
It's very, very good for the beginners. And again, what is important here is that if you're pretty regular, it's easy, you just have to add more loads or even play with the time if you guys want to target regular people. So now let's imagine that you have a class, you have to design a class, it's a secret class. So yes, you're going to do 8 exercises like I sent it to you in the group. We have 2 ways of doing this, either by reps or either by time. What is the most effective or what do you prefer if you have to choose? Whatever the reason is, are you prefer to doing the reps or maybe working with time?
I prefer working with time.
Yeah. Time.
Why?
Yeah.
Because you can gauge how long the class is going to take.
Yeah, very good
point.
Anything else?
It depends on the auditory as well, but the time is going to be more beneficial because some of the members might going to be with the slow tempo.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
The time is much better.
Yeah. And this is why when we're doing
either
of the exercises, we need to in a class kind of structure, it's way better to target the time. Because anyone can follow and it's easy and you can even use a timer.
Yes.
And it's also to kind of target everyone because we're saying that the class is for everyone. So they can go on their own timing, they can go on the lower range for rest, they can rest in between. They don't have to do the full 45 seconds if they can achieve it. And again, it's their own weight. Now, from what I sent it to you was 8 exercises. What do you think is the best? To do 8 station and then they move? Or everyone to take this own equipment and stay on the spot and we do the same?
It depends on your attendees. If you have a lot of attendees, it's better to do one exercise after another. If we have less attendees, then stations would be okay.
Yes.
Good point. So if we're doing a class and we only 6,
make stationary?
You can make stations.
I mean, more useful because like,
they
might have different way.
The bar. So
for example, for the squat, they might be able to use bigger weights than just for shoulder
press. Okay, that's a great idea. So the best is to keep in your own space, right? And if you're moving, and if you have someone that's running late, what's going to happen?
It's
going to
mess the
structure. Yeah. So for safety reason and also to make it more simple, either for you or for members, it's better to have it stationary. So you guys stay on your spots and you have everything you need. You have your bench, your barbell, your plate, and you're going to use the board to just write the exercise. So even if you're late, okay guys, it's a secret class. We're just performing 8 exercises back to back, 45 seconds, 15 seconds off. Here's the exercise. In the bar, a bench, and some free plates. So while you keep going with the others, those people that are late, they can still grab the things and
prepare.
get to know what's happening, and then start to move, to go with the flow. So you're fine. So now here's the deal. Anyone want to grab a bar, put weight in the bar, can put 1 kilo, 2.5, 5 kilo, doesn't matter, and take 3 plates of 5. Let's go. And just put in yourself some snacks.
You can't hide them. You can't hide.
Expand
them the other move. All right, 30 seconds, there's a 15 seconds. Your next move will be standing, will be a single dead row. All right, 5 seconds. Stand up, rest, 15 seconds to get ready. I'll show you again, one more time. It's a single row. You're going down, pull, down and up. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Exercise number 3. Now we're working the back. Yeah, just a little bit. Yeah, and you stand up. For my senior. Overhead grip.
Come on.
Listen up, 30 seconds, you have 15 seconds more. Keep going.
Hey, George, probably go right
up there. Yes, have a look. Your next move would be a bicep curl. Right, hold, recover, underhand grip. Next move, bicep curl. And it's doing as a, it's actually a root class.
Let's go!
back for the second time, second round, exactly the same exercise. So what you're gonna say from there, okay guys, if you felt it easier, start to add some load. So they have 1 minute to decide if they want to put more weight. It's the same exercise. So what they just did, they worked actually the full body, and we went very simple. Squat on the legs, then we went for the chest, on the press, went for the back with the rows. Then we do the biceps, triceps, shoulders, core. Just exercise. Of course, you're free to choose your exercise. If you prefer to do some alternated bicep curl, or if you want to do a tricep extension with the barbell or on the bench, whatever you want, as long as you target the same muscle group. So I did this drill on purpose. The first drill I did was just to explain what's going to happen. So I told you the workout, 25 seconds, 15 seconds, and take the barbell. It was very dry. Like, it was very like, okay, we know what to do, but there was no music, there was nothing. And then after the fourth round, when you guys get to know what's going to happen, I just put some music. And you always, everyone get a little bit more excited. Because there is music. You need to start to dance already. And this is why we exercise on the music. Because it's dry, people. It's harder. So we really train, actually. And then it was confusing, because when I was screaming 50 seconds, did you see how hard it is to understand what's going to happen? Because I don't have mic. So it's just like, what's the exercise? So you have to see, but at the same time, I don't understand you. And people think, without using a mic, that people understand. People don't. They just say, okay, but I will just wait for you to show. Because not understand what you say. And I went to take the mic in the last two rounds, but there's something wrong with the setup, so my voice was really low, so I couldn't really decide. But this is what I want to follow up on last week. Using your mic is very important because it will drive your setup. So we just saw your secret for body training. So remember, your class has a warm up, your workout, which is this or two times. And then you're either with great stretching or maybe you can go for a finisher and stretching. Let's say we have 5 minutes for the warm-up. Depends. You can run, you can do some squat, whatever exercise that might be in the workout. Just for them to move with light weights. Then they recover, they rest for 30 seconds to explain the workout. What's going to happen? Is this, is this, and this, and this, and this. Okay? Boom. They work. So 9 minutes plus 4 minutes by 2, so 90 minutes. Plus the 5 minutes, so 24 minutes. So we still have 60 minutes to go. So you can go for a 2 minute finisher and then just stretch. The 2 minute finisher can be hold the plank for 2 minutes, be 2 minutes, as many burpees as you can for 2 minutes, but be creative. The last thing they will do is what they will remember. So they need to actually, it's a finisher, so they have to not die, but has to be hard. Maybe some push-ups. As many push-ups as you can in 2 minutes. That would be a challenge for them. And then just stretch and 20 minutes from your workout is done. And you don't even have to think about it. You have your exercise and everything is set. We just saw the structure of the class. How to set up and what's going to happen in the class. So, in your next meeting, it's going to be the same exercise, but now we're going to have a look in how can you actually conduct the class. It's not about like your lazy speaker. It's not about approaching day one, day two, day three. But it's just what we need to say for them to start to move and be safe. So you're going to see also the technique part. But we still need your feedback on the actual specific class. What do you think a member would feel if you just come from nowhere? From nowhere, actually literally nowhere, to come to the class?
to go through your
okay, what I'm going to do is self awareness is okay, it's fine. Self awareness is the key. You don't have to go crazy. So guys, that was just for me the delivering of the workout, because I know that we always say to you, yes, if you're ready to cover, you have to be ready and to know what to do. But again, I don't want it to give you kind of it's support. It's like, you can change the exercise, obviously, as long as you're working with your body. It's totally free to you. And later on, we're going to see the same for some cardio class. What can we do? It's the same. Yeah. So yeah, for next round, there will be more about the coaching phase, how can we say it, and really perform the class, actually, with real weights, for you to really experience the class and see that, okay, this would be great for participants. Or maybe it's too easy, or maybe it's too hard. You have to try by yourself, especially if you design the program. Raise your hands if you have any questions regarding the workout.